Howdy folks, and welcome to episode 19 of a Minecraft Let's Play series. As you can see, as promised in the last episode, I got this done. I did not do the glass yet. I did get a lot of sand, but I haven't put the glass in yet because, well, I just hadn't done it. This project right here took me a lot longer than I thought it would. I severely underestimated this. I kept the shape of the lake where it fell short of the overhang here. So underneath, that's why you have glowstone right there next to dirt, and yeah, that's why it's like that. Is I was keeping the shape of the lake to make it look like this was built into the ground and all that. It's working. I'm not displeased with it. But I was going through doing all this and I noticed something that was a little bit frustrating. I didn't touch this up here because it's going to change. And how is it going to change? Well, like this. This is crap. All of it. The problem I'm having with this wonderful industrial furnace is tick speeds. Tick speeds are screwing everything up. So I'm ripping it out. We're starting over. This furnace doesn't work. You see how these five are nice and lit up, but then this one's full of coal. Absolutely nothing in it. And then that one's full. That one's full. We come over on this side. 62, 47. No consistency at all. This one's completely empty. Right between a 63 and a 64. And the reason this is happening is the tick speeds in 1.9 are all messed up. I don't know what to do with it. So I'm ripping it out and we're going to use those powered rails that I promised a couple episodes ago. I'm going to make a minecart industrial furnace. And so I'm going to go ahead and finish clearing this out. Give us a nice blank slate and I'll bring you back when it's done. All right. We have cleared all this mess out and oops, I missed a block. Oh no. I missed two blocks. Okay. There we go. Now all cleared out and I took the input lines all the way back to there. I mean, here we go. Where is it? Yeah, I took out the output line as well, all the way back to here. That will probably get moved. I'm not sure exactly where. Let me see here. Where is it anyway? It's going all the way over to here. So I could put my output right here, somewhere in this area. Because what I was thinking I was going to do, let me see here. We'll just use that as a placeholder. Let's see. I need one row for the coal input. Okay. And then that's it. Too deep. That's it. How easy is that? Okay, well, then where's it going to come in from? That's a good question. Well, you know, I do have these right here, all the way on this back side. What I could is just have this, yeah. How many is that? That would be a nice long line. If I ran this whole length right here as furnaces, just a straight line of furnaces, had my output here, and then my two input lines feeding these guys right here, which would then run along the tracks all the way down and then back. Okay. So let's see here. This is one, two in, and then I'm going to have some kind of a wall here to hide all this. Okay, so that's what, three blocks in? All right, let's come over this end. And we got one, two, three. Okay. There we go. So if my last furnace goes here, and the first one, is that right? No, that's two. Is it two? I can't count. Okay, there's two glass there. Okay, and over here I got one glass. Okay, fix this. There we go. And we'll just do that. Like so. Okay, there we go. Now, the input be there. And then that's the fuel input. Was going to be a hopper that is like so. Let me throw this on here. There we go. That's a fuel input. Okay. And then we have a material input and then the output. Yeah. Okay. We will send, we're going to send the output down right here. And then the rest of these, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, 17. Oh, I ran out. 18, 19, 20. Okay, here we go. There we go. There's my output line. You know what? I have the furnaces. Might as well. Where'd it go? Give me that. Okay. Let's go ahead and stick the furnaces in here. Right, like so. Holding down the shift, holding down the shift. Okay. We're getting there. Slowly but surely. This is going to use a lot less hoppers than the previous design. And it's a simpler all-around design. I mean, this is much easier. I don't know why I didn't do this to start with. I didn't think of it. Didn't even occur to me. I don't know why. Sometimes I wonder about me. All right, now just go down the line, popping in hoppers. There we go. Almost there, almost there. And last one. There we go. Excuse me. Now, throw in the fuel input out the back. See, I end up with more furnaces and fewer hoppers. How dumb is it that I didn't think of that first? Man. All right. And there we go. Done. You know what? Am I going? I might end up putting that back. I'm not sure. All right. There we go. That's essentially it. Uses a lot fewer hoppers. You can get more furnaces going. Now, we need our powered rail. Now, the powered rail is going to be a little bit tricky, simply because to power the rail, you also end up powering the hoppers, and a powered hopper won't accept anything, at least I think. We're going to have to test it. All right. I'll throw these guys in up here. Come on. I think it's funny, you still fall into the hoppers when you're standing on rails. I think rails should kind of be like trap doors. You can't fall through them. Whatever. Because, I mean, their hitbox is the same size as a trapdoor. Okay, so now I got to figure out how to power the powered rails without powering the hoppers. I wonder if that can even be done. Okay, it's gone nighttime. Let's hope nothing spawns anywhere near us. Because that would kind of suck. Alright, let me switch to some blocks here. Excuse me, sorry. So here we got one. Well, I need to have my loading station. So we'll say there's probably going to be 4 or 5 rail there. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay, and I wanted to see what this does. Ooh. Ooh, look at that. Now, let me see here if... Awesome, it doesn't stop the hopper. Give me that. That works. I will take it. All right. So I just do that. I need... That was a 10... Well, I'll start here. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. There we go. And power... Oh, it's got to come in one. What a shame. All right. That's fine. That's fine. Get out of there. Oh, you couldn't give me the damn thing. Really? Whatever. There we go. Now, all my rails are powered. All the way down both ends. Excellent. All right. Moving on. All right. Now we got a little bit of platform here. Let's see. Oh, nope. I want that to be powered. So let me get my powered rail down here. I don't think I need the sword right this second. Okay, and then we'll set that guy there and that guy there. And we'll stick another powered rail right there. There we go. All right. Now, I just need to power the rail. let me over here. How am I going to do this? Underneath. There we go. Boom. And, yeah, that one. And then, will one be enough? Does that get both of them? Nope, just one. Darn it. Okay, that's fine. There we go. Both of them are powered. So, what that will do is after the cart has filled up, it'll shoot on down the line here, load all these hoppers up, and it'll just loop around and come back for a second pass before going back to the refilling station. Which I'll have to figure out how I'm going to do that. Okay, so let's repeat that here. We've got that there, power drill, and then that guy there, and that guy there, and power drill. Oh, sweet. That works. I'll accept it. So now I just need to power this other one. Can I do that? Let me get that out of the way. Okay. Yeah. Oh, no. Bad. No. Oh, why did I do that? Get back up there. I gotta fix this. Powered rail. Okay, fixed. Okay, so that's fine. How am I gonna get you? Apparently, I'm going to go for a swim. I don't want to. I don't want to swim. Not ideal. There we go. Alright, so I'll just knock that out, and bam. There we go. All powered. All good to go. Excellent. We shouldn't have any problems now. So there's the loop around. Now, this refilling station, this top one is material to be cooked. And I honestly can't remember which one of these is which. But you know what? I don't think it matters. I think I can switch them. And I think by switching them, I will actually save hoppers, because I think my hoppers are doing something stupid back here. Let me see here. I can't really tell. Screw it. We'll go for a swim. Let's see here. This one's coming way out here before going into that. Okay, and yeah, this is the cooking material, and that's the fuel line. Okay, so the fuel line is that one, and okay. All right, let's get back up there. Did it. Come on, let's go. Here we go. Oh, there we go. Okay, difficulties. Come up here. So if that's my fuel line, it needs to fill up something that's going to go this way and then meet up here, because this is the fuel track right here. So to do that, let me get out of there. Nope, give me hoppers. Gimme. Oh, where'd that go? In here. Awesome. Okay. And you're probably gonna have to change direction too. Okay. Don't fall down there. Okay, that's my input for miscellaneous stuff. So I'm going to need that guy right there. And, I've got a thought. I do have half slabs. Awesome. All right. We will put a regular block there and a slab there. And a regular block there. All right. Well, that seems pretty easy. Is it though? Let me throw that guy right there. I didn't leave myself much room to work with. So this is being a little Okay. And we'll just okay. That's good. Now my refilling, I actually think I need to take this back a block. So, like that. Yeah. Alright. Let me set another temporary block right there. And I don't do this. I need larger inventory. There we go. Okay, so I could have left that. But that's fine. That's fine. It's okay. Oh, man, I did not mean to take out all that. Okay, we gotta fix that now, because I'm just breaking everything. Okay. Now, I'm going to put that guy right there. And we're going to throw our powered rails right like that. Excellent. And actually, that one right there. Okay. Yes. Take that one back out. That one I want to be a detector rail, because I want to put a comparator on here to detect when the this is going to detect when the minecart chest is filled up, and then tell it to go. But how am I going to do this? Because, I've got that right there. It's rather inconvenient. Oh, maybe it's not. Get out of there, stupid. Ooh. Did I just get lucky? I did. I don't need that to be powered, though. Well, I don't even need that there. There. Okay, so I'll leave it temporarily a hole, but there we go. Excellent, 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 excellent. So I need my, okay, oh crap, I fell. All right, so there's that. Excellent, now I, oh boy. But then I run into another issue of how in the hell, oh, ow, crap, okay, no, that's not going to work either. You know what, I'm going to have to move this, I'm just going to have to shift it all around, move everything around, to make it fit a little bit better. So, I'm going to go ahead and get on with that. I'm going to tear down these little mini item elevators. I think. Is that what I want to do? Yeah. Yep, the mini item elevators, I'm going to tear them down so that I can shift this stuff around and make this work a little bit better, because I can already tell this is going to frustrate me. This is, the item elevator itself is a little bit too tall, so I can't put a very good stopping mechanism in here to stop the minecart while it fills up. I could probably do it sideways, coming in from the side. Like if I put a piston right here, well, no. It'd have to be up here. Piston right there with a glass block on it. But then I've got redstone wrapping around the pillar, and it's going to be ugly and messy. So I'm going to go ahead and work on fixing this with the item elevators and get them where I want them. And I'll bring you guys right back. And we're back. And I got it done. And guess what? I didn't need dropper elevators over here. Instead, what I do is I lowered the tracks down all the way down to the bottom so that the hoppers would load right into the carts. Put in these pistons to stop the carts, let them load up. Right here on the back side, and I switched them around, switched the lines. So this one right here is the fuel line. This one's going to, actually, this one's already got fuel in it, still loading into it. This one is my materials line, and this is the one that I put the comparator on. I didn't bother on this one. This one, I'm just going to let fuel constantly load into that. Because, no matter how I did this, I could not manage to get a redstone signal from this comparator over to my hopper clock over here without locking the hoppers for the fuel line. I could lower it down and get it down in this area, but I've already got the hoppers popping down here for the output line. I didn't want to have too much under here. I tried to make this look nice, so I just said, you know what, the fuel line doesn't need its own hopper clock and all that. It doesn't need a trigger. The only thing that needs a trigger is the materials line. So the hopper clock I used, one hopper points into the next, points into that one, points into this one, points into this one. Whenever there are materials in the hopper, the comparator detects it, sends out a signal, locks the hopper next to it so that items can flow through. And then this one will pick up a signal, lock this hopper so that items will flow on through. And it just goes around and around. Gives you a couple of minutes on the timer. And the reason I did this is so whenever this cart starts receiving materials, it'll send the signal through, turn off this redstone torch, which will unlock this hopper, allowing items to flow in this one, starting the clock until it comes all the way back around to here. When this hopper starts receiving items, it will send a signal up the torch tower, and it'll go to both pistons, unlocking both of them so that the fuel and the materials can both take off, and it'll keep them open for a little while, allowing the carts to go back and forth a few times, unloading their inventory. Let me see here. Do I have anything on? No. Let me grab some materials real quick to cook. There we go. Let me put a couple of these things back up here. I definitely don't need that. We'll just grab some netherrack because that'll work. And I have to put it in after the filter. If I put it in before the filter, it'll just go on upstairs and end up in that last hopper since I don't have anything for it. I just pick a hopper and start throwing them in. Now you see, there it is. The first item made it into the cart, and now the clock has started. And whenever it makes it all the way around to this one right here, it'll send that signal up and unlock it, and we'll be able to see these take off. And we're going to see just how well it works. There they go. Look at that. Every single furnace lit up. And they just, there they go, man. That is just too awesome. I couldn't get that with the previous furnace design. No matter what I tried to do with all that mess, it just wasn't working. But here, I've still got two stacks of hoppers left over. As you can see, I've got the output line put in. So, as these items cook, they're just going to go right on through. And it's done. I can't believe it. You know, it's a little framey. That's probably because of the item elevator. But yeah, they're just going to keep on going. And there it is. The clock went through. Now it's going to lock them. Bam. And now this one is picking up more items. So the comparator is picking up the signal. Start the clock again. Whenever the clock makes its round and this chest has got quite a few items in it, they're both going to take off again and unload their inventory. I am very pleased with this and how it turned out. So now, we need to do something about how this looks. Look at that. Oh, that is so cool. I love it. Okay. So now we need to kind of decorate this up a little bit. I'm going to throw in some upside down stairs. And let's go. Come on. Here we go. Here we go. Be something. All right. And along the bottom. There it goes again. I love it. Oh, I love it when things work. All right. And almost there. And done. Okay, so now it's got a little bit of dressing to it. And how many of these did I end up with? 26. Okay, so 26. That's not exactly easy to work with. Yep, there it goes. It's going to lock them down. It's beautiful. I love it. And there it goes, picking up more. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. All right. I'm going to go ahead and throw these in here. Let's see here. That's going to completely hide the minecarts up until this point. But Yeah, you're not going to see them anyway. Because I'm also going to wall this off. Probably to just here. But this wall is going to come out and up, and you're not ever going to see them. All right. I think, is that, yeah. Ooh, just barely enough. Okay. So we'll just go ahead and throw up another row like that. All right. There we go. Awesome. Now I have a beautiful industrial furnace that works. Every furnace is being used. Nothing wasted. Now, uh-oh, it got dark. Uh-oh. Let's hope nothing sneaks up on me. All right. Let us see how much we got. So just with these two little runs right here, that it's or three runs. Last hopper. Oh, no, piece of glass I lost. Yeah, look at that. It is filling up nicely. Oh, I love it. Oh, how I love it. It works. Okay. So yeah, that's the furnace. Final version. Oh, man. Look at that. Oh, that is so beautiful. I love it when it does that. All right. So, things I'm going to work on. Off camera, I'm going to hide this machine area where all my redstone is and the clock and all that. Pretty much, let me get over here. From these pillars, this line of pillars right here, to this line of pillars is going to be completely blocked off. Because that's going to be a redstone room where all this crap is hidden away. And then I'm going to bring this guy out to here. So we'll have a nice corner right here. I'm going to do the same thing over there. And I haven't decided yet, I might push this back so that I don't have to have anything bulging out here to cover it up. But then again, I might not. I might just leave it like it is, sticking out there, because it is a nice quick access to it in case something goes wrong. Shouldn't, since it has overflow protection on it, but if something goes wrong, I like being able to just get up there and fix it. But yeah, that's going to do it for today, folks. This is it. The Industrial Furnace Version 2 Final Version. We are not changing this again. It works, and it works very well. So, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye now.